Hi. Well, I don't know how anyone else is doing this, but these are the heavy duty connectors that Signature Solder's selling. That's still gonna be pretty hot. We're gonna have a really good connection. I put some solder on that wire. Then I heated up this connector. It's still pretty warm, so I'm not gonna touch it right away. And after it cools off a minute, I'm gonna go ahead and put the connector on. And after I get the connector on, then I can go ahead and do the other one. Now, on these ends, you'll notice that these are the old connectors. And what we're doing is we're gonna put the heavy duty connectors on from the solar panels coming this way and use these on, you know, connecting to the solar panels because this is what they have. But I like to solder my connections. That way I'm getting a good connection in there, no matter what type of connector I've got. And, you know, these are, that's very, very well connected. that ain't gonna pull off or nothing like that when you take the connectors apart. So I just wanted to touch basis on how this is gonna be working. So see how, yeah, we can touch that. I'm just trying to twist that a little bit, that way I don't got nothing sticking out. Makes it easier to solder it. This is a Milwaukee solder gun. So when it turns solid green, that's heated up. Get them wires warmed up a little bit. Thank you. that works much better. When you get, when you cut the wire without the plastic sheath, it bends it, and then you mess up what you're trying to do. So try to cut your wire with the metal or the plastic sheath still on it. We're going to heat that up a little bit. Just get a little bit of a contact between the solder, the wire, and the connector. When you turn the Milwaukee solder iron off, you're not supposed to take the battery off until that light goes out. That light will stay red. You want to line up those connectors when you put it together, just like that. Although this goes to my panels, and this one is going to go to the other connectors that are going to come in here. I just wanted to show you how I did that. In your regular tools do not work. That's why I'm using two screwdrivers. Regular MC4 connector tools will not work on these. But that's how simple that is. And by using the solder, you have a good connection, and you can always tin your wires when you're putting them into your inverters. So if you tin your wires when you put them into your inverters, you don't have loose strands. So it makes it a little bit simpler. So I just figured I'd show you how I was doing my new connectors. I got a bag of connectors from Signature Solar, the heavy duty ones. And figured I'd show you how I did that. That way people ask, you know, hey, you know. So try to make sure you cut the wire, or strip the wire at the right length for your connectors, because when you cut it off after you've already stripped it, it doesn't want to stay all the way round, and it don't want to go together. So then when you put your solder in there, it don't want to fit. And so I'm going to leave that on the video. That way you guys can see from my mistake and what I've learned as I went. And hopefully that helps you guys. But it's just putting the heavy duty MC4 connectors together and making it work, you know. I hope that was helpful to some of you guys. I'm replacing these wires, you know, and we'll just come out here when it's dark. And what all you do is you measure it, get it where you, the length you want it, and then you can go ahead and swap them out. I'm gonna do that when they're not generating any power. Just trying to make sure everything's working the way it's supposed to. I hope this helps some of you guys. Thank you. Please like, comment, and subscribe.